The example here says we have a sort of system that has three users. The users are A, B, C, because rows correspond to users. And we have three resources as well. We're calling them X, Y, and Z. These are three objects of the resources we have. And if you look at the matrix, it says, well, A can read, write, execute. Object X can only read object Y and has no access to object Z. B can read, write Y and can read, execute Z, and things like that. So this matrix actually tells you who can do what, given the three users and the three resources we have. So if you want to implement the information that's in this access control matrix, well, using ACLs, then we look at what's at the top here. So what would ACLs or ACLs correspond to objects? So the first object is X. First go down, you find user A who has read, write, execute permission. So that's an entry in the list that we're going to, actually in this case, the list is only going to have one entry because B has no access, C has no access. Those are null entries that we don't need to represent in this list. So the ACL for X is just going to be this one entry, which has user A can read, write, and execute this object. Still talking about ACLs, if you look at Y, the second resource we have here, actually here we're going to have three entries in the ACL, one for each user. A is going to be able to read it, B can read, write it, C can read, write it too. Similarly, for the last resource, we're going to have two entries. A has no access, but B and C do. So B can read and execute it, and C can read and execute as well. So this information that we have in the access control matrix gets represented with three access control lists, one for each object. This is for X, for Y, and for Z. Another way to represent this very same information is using capability lists or C lists. So remember, C lists are per user. So we have to have a C list for A, one for user B, and one for user C. If you look at A, it has access to both X and Y. So the C list would have two entries. So user A has access for resource X, and the access rights are read, write, execute. Similarly, user A can read resource Y. So this is the C list for user A. Similarly, C list for user B is going to no access for resource X, so nothing for X, but for Y, we're going to have read, write access. And similarly, for Z, we're going to have read, execute access. So this C list is going to have two entries. And the C list is going to look the same for user C because B and C have same kind of access, the given set of resources that we have here. ACLs, you go vertical per resource. C lists, you go horizontal or row-wise per user. So we're talking about how you implement an access control matrix. Well, one way is to define or have these lists that we have, and we'll talk about where these lists get stored or maintained. But the ACL or ACM information gets captured either in ACLs or in C lists.